members who are not students in the conventional sense necessarily. This is what we find in the market today. In spite of the fact our clientele is slightly different, different from conventional system, different from all other universities. A teenage school dropout, a person forced into labor market, a person who is serving in the armed forces, defense personnel, a person who is convicted in the jail, a person who wants horizontal and vertical mobility, a person who has been born out of ICT revolution, who does not believe in the four-wall regime. I think we have to constantly look for as to whom we are serving if we want to provide the right direction to the ODL interventions. We have to reach all of them. And there are some recent, I don't want to repeat others which are known, attempts which we have made. Number one, we have recently started remote access to e-resources, RATE service. Majority of the information today is available in e-form. Keeping with the time is that our library, the IGNU library, has provided access to 75,000 e-journals, 1,700 e-books, and 60 databases to all sections of the ODL community on the internet 24/7 from anywhere, irrespective of their place of location. This is something which we have already taken up through the library. The challenging task in this endeavor was to provide off-campus access from locations outside the IP range in addition to on-campus access to authorized users, but without the framework of copyright laws. At present, the licensed e-resources are accessible to faculties, to academics, and research scholars. The library has plans to extend the access to each and every learner. And at present, such learners from study centers can visit nearby regional centers to use this facility. We have also started recently DelNet facility. No library can afford to sustain on its own today. In view of the explosion of information, IGNU library provides access to resources of more than 4,000 libraries through DelNet, developing library network. Access to these resources is provided to users in headquarters as well as regional centers. I'm very happy that our library has given it a slogan, every user, he or her, information at the click of a mouse is the motto of the library they have decided. We are also seriously engaged, madam, in teacher education, which has been your area of interest also. Considering the commitment of the RTA Act 2009, in India, we are supposed to have trained or likely to train around 700,000 teachers by March 2015, which is not possible by the conventional system of training. We thought that IGNU can substantially contribute in training of untrained teachers, and we have made a dent in offering a number of teacher education programs, which among others include the Diploma in Elementary Education, B.Ed. and M.Ed. You'll be very happy to know that IGNU has recently signed MOCs with 5 northeastern states. One with Government of Arunachal Pradesh to train 8,889 teachers, with Manipur to train 6,583 teachers, with Mizoram to train 8,636 teachers, with Sikkim to train 546 teachers, and with Tripura just recently this month, 11,884 teachers. This is something which we have taken up very seriously, and we know that we have the capacity and capability to deliver. I myself personally consider that there is a paradigm shift taking place in education. I think the whole emphasis is on employability. If today we ask any student, you know, I am offering a diploma, would you like to take it? The simple question he asks us, can it provide me employment? If yes, he jumps on it, does not ask even the credentials of the university. If we say no, then he asks us many questions. I think our focus also has to be, and we are trying to have, our entire focus on employability. We have taken certain steps in this direction. One is that we have started reshaping our BDP program. It's no fun students walking out of IGNO with a simple BDP degree. We wanted to add now some courses which will increase the employability of these students when they go out with this BA certificate. I think we had a BN Cole committee, they have submitted their report, we have accepted it, board has also agreed with it. We are now identifying those courses which can be put into it and how can we reshape our BDP program. There's something, you know, because large numbers, the students join our BDP program. We have also taken up, which was earlier with us from 2006 in the area of skill development, IGNO HMCL Motorcycle Technician Competency Development Project with Hero Motors. Now, it is a collaborative initiative of the IGNO and the Hero Motor Corporation Limited towards the competency-based skill development training for existing motorcycle technicians and educated raw learners of the country. We have so far trained 11,500 learners have already been trained and certified under the program through its existing 43 training centers. What we have recently done, number one, we are reshaping this program. We are signing a fresh MOC with the Hero Motors. And apart from this 3 months training program, we are also developing and designing a 6 month full-fledged certificate program which can be offered by the university through ODL mode, with the help of all these training centers of the Hero Motors spread across the country. This will be something which we'll be doing in the area of, which will perhaps bring some positive results as far as the skill development is concerned. We have also been very serious about making our interventions in the jails. As on today, in 58 jails across the country, we have our centers there. We had recently a conference of the superintendents of these jails, and we found that not only that we are giving them free education, but a lot of things are happening. Recently, there was a jail inmate, ma'am, in Tehar jail, who was offered a package of 4.5 lakh. And it so happens that he's a student of IGNO and doing social work degree with us. Like that, we are finding a lot of people who are based in various jails who are progressing like this and getting various offers. I think we should acknowledge that, we should encourage that. We also had an e-African, pan-e-African network project, which is a little bit on hold, but actually the proposal which was approved by the cabinet was that there will be an India-Africa virtual university and implementing agency will be the IGNO and the Ministry of Human Resource Development. There has been some diplomatic, you know, discussions going on, and we have been asked to wait for some time, continue with the African Pan-African Network project for some time till the discussions with the African Union are taken to some logical end. That will add to our visibility across the African continent. We have also been recently entrusted by the Government of India that if we can play a role in developing accreditation parameters for ODL in the country. And some of you know that we recently had last week fourth conference of the vice chancellors of the state open universities where we have discussed this proposal, and hopefully we are developing some mechanism to put these accreditation parameters in place and submit it to the government so that an agency, an autonomous agency, is created for accreditation of ODL programs in the country. It's again a very heavy responsibility being laid down on IGNO. I think, finally, IGNO has to emerge and function as an institution. The university is committed to quality and excellence in all its activities, teaching, research, training, extension. We are re-establishing norms for program evaluation, performance indicators for operations of systems, mechanisms to inject vibrancy in assessment and evaluation, and rewarding merit. In brief, we plan to initiate the process of academic audit and engage in a serious exercise to revise our courses, existing courses, both print and audiovisual, by incorporating information on the latest developments in all areas of study. We have to have a serious look at schools and disciplines in order to designate the better performing disciplines and schools, centers as institutions of center of excellence. We are planning to develop an ever evolving mechanism for continuing professional development for teaching and support staff. We want to take education to the unreached and the disadvantaged sections of the society in order to mainstream them for national development. I think finally, we want to promote the superlative of excellence in student support services. We are making all our efforts to make our student services more student friendly. This is how we are looking at IGNO, and this particular event today gives us an occasion to look back and also to look at what is ahead of us so that we can take the mission of Professor G. Ram Reddy forward. Once again, I pay my sincere tributes to Professor Ram Reddy, and I sincerely and wholeheartedly welcome the President of the Commonwealth of Learning as the main speaker today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. A short documentary on Professor G. Ram Reddy will now be screened.
From a lower middle class family, and I am the first generation literate. My father is not very well read. Then I joined the college, Nizam College in Hyderabad. From there I did my intermediate BA and MA. Afterwards I went to the Lamb School of Economics, where I studied public administration. Came back and joined Usmania University as a lecturer. Well, throughout I served in that university, lecturer, reader, professor, principal, and vice-chancellor for 2 terms. Later on, we started the Open University in Andhra Pradesh, but that is a state university. I came to Delhi to set up this university. First, to prepare the project document, then prepare the bill, and finally start the university.
Professor G. Ram Reddy, the architect of India's open and distance education system, had his beginnings in a humble rural area of the former Nizam's dominion. He was born to farming parents of modest means on 4th December 1929, during the colonial era. He grew up witnessing the great revolution that was taking place in the country. No doubt, he saw his role in the context of enriching the Indian minds through education.
Between the convocation of a conventional university and that of an open university, Lord Briggs once said, I quote, In the convocation of a former university, the proud parents go to take the photographs of their children, while in the open university, it is the proud children who go to take the photographs of their parents.
Professor Ram Reddy, coming from a rural background and first generation scholar, he was always trying to spot out people who come from the rural background and try to help them, assist them, knowing fully well that the disabilities and disadvantage that the rural boys suffer.
I think the best way to remember Professor Ram Reddy is to look back. To look back to a time when Indira Gandhi National Open University was inaugurated by the then Prime Minister of India. And in the inaugural speech, the then Prime Minister on 19th of November 1985 said, and I quote, "Our endeavor is that in India, the poorest, the most backward children receive the best possible education. And in this direction, today, we are to take a step forward. This open university will extend educational opportunities to all corners of the country," unquote. This is how Indira Gandhi National Open University was founded.
My beliefs are liberal beliefs, more or less the ones which were propagated by, that time propagated in India by Pandit Nehru and others.
Shaped by his experiences and convictions, he became an early achiever, making and leaving his mark wherever he went and whichever positions he held.
From UK, I should join the private sector. But under the influence of the Labour Party, we felt that we should not serve the private sector. Therefore, I joined as a lecturer. And once I joined as a lecturer, there was no other ambition except to continue in the profession. When you are a lecturer, you want to become a reader. When you are a reader, you want to become a professor. All that, I must say, I've been able to get that these promotions fairly quickly and rapidly. Maybe the society was very generous to me, very kind to me. I became Vice Chancellor at that time, fairly young age, 47.
Considering the conditions in the university at that time, I called a group of four people. The unanimous choice of all those four was Professor Ram Reddy. So that means he was liked, universally liked by all sections of the university. I went to Sri Rangalavaru and told him, "Sir, I have consulted everybody, and the name I have to suggest is Professor G. Ram Reddy." At that time, some other minister was sitting there when I was talking to the Chief Minister. That minister said, "But sir, he is a very young man, how can he be Vice Chancellor?" So I told him, "Sir, Professor V.K. Arvi Rao was appointed at an even younger age as Vice Chancellor. We should also set an example of appointing young people as Vice Chancellor." "Yes," Agarwal said, "yes, it's a good point." So he appointed him as Vice Chancellor.
He was instrumental in creating the Association of Asian Open Universities. He was one of the members who had created the Commonwealth of Learning in the beginning. He had propagated the setting up of open universities even in the African region. And in this respect, one could say that he was a beacon light for distance education.
The COL-ICDE award for excellence in distance education was conferred to him just before his death in 1995. The award was an eloquent recognition to his multiple talents and achievements.
Professor Ram Reddy's greatest contribution to India, perhaps, is the open and distance education system. Despite the many initial resistances and challenges he faced, the passion to educate the much-needed population continued to drive him until he, with his team, created a system that was convincing, reliable, innovative, and above all, the answer to India's educational needs.
People like me were not very enthusiastic, we were very skeptical, and any number of times I argued with him, sir, if you start an open university, it will end up as a correspondence course, and correspondence courses have diluted the quality of education, and why do you toy with this idea of a distance education? You will be legitimizing the poor quality education. Then any number of times he argued with me that you people are not understanding one thing, that educational needs are increasing. There is a huge demand for higher education. There are a number of people who can't afford, number of people who want to improve their qualifications after joining the jobs, and there are the number of housewives who would like to improve their qualifications, and there is a big demand. And today, technology has developed in such a way the technology can take education to the doorstep of the individuals. They don't need to come to the learning place, but the learning can go to their doorstep.
After Shri Rajiv Gandhi took over as the Prime Minister, the stage was set, the stage was right, and Professor Ram Reddy had done the prototype in the Andhra Pradesh, as Andhra Pradesh Open University, that whether an open university could bridge the gap. Then therefore obviously they identified him and Mr. Narasimha Rao as the HRD minister. Really.